Well, friends, we've been hearing about the corruption that has been going on in Tamil Nadu. I'm sure many of you are already familiar with that. Along with the corruption, we are also seeing a weakening or destruction of anti-corruption institutions such as the Right to Information Act, as well as the Lok Ayukt here. A lot of people believe, and I also believe, that the Tamil Nadu government today is being run by remote control from Delhi by the central government. The central government in turn, and the Prime Minister who is in office today, came to power more than 4 years ago on a campaign that he is going to remove corruption in the country, bring back all black money, that he will appoint a Lokpal, a strong Lokpal, and that he will bring Ram Raj in this country. But what happened? Has corruption disappeared from the central government? Has black money been brought back? Many of you must be familiar. Some people say that there hasn't been any major scam under this government like there was under the previous government, like the 2G scam or the Colgate scam. But many of you must be by now familiar with the Rafale deal. This is a deal for 36 Rafale fighter aircrafts, which the Prime Minister himself entered into with the French government and this Dassault company of France, in which 36 Rafale jets are to be purchased from this Dassault company for 60,000 crores. Now, this decision of the Prime Minister was taken exactly 2 weeks after the Dassault company, along with the Indian Air Force, along with officers from Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, which is the India's public sector company having long experience in manufacturing aircrafts. That Dassault chief executive officer said in a press conference that we have nearly finalized an ongoing contract, which was a contract which was under in the process from 2007 onwards, for purchase by India of 126 Rafale planes, out of which 18 were to be purchased directly from Dassault and 108 were to be manufactured by the Hindustan Aeronautics factory under a transfer of technology agreement with this French company, Dassault. And this decision, as I said, had been taken in 2007 when the Indian Air Force said that we need 126 aircrafts, fighter aircrafts. And thereafter, the Indian government, the entire government, had decided that out of these 126 aircraft, 18 would be directly purchased and 108 would be manufactured in India by our own factory under transfer of technology, so that India could be self-sufficient in the manufacture of these aircrafts. And this contract was almost finalized by 2015, by 25th March 2015. And the price of each aircraft was to have been around 700 crores, under 700 crores. And yet 2 weeks after that, the Prime Minister himself completely changed that contract and made it into a contract of purchasing only 36 planes directly from this Dassault company of France, by increasing the cost of each plane from almost 700 crores to 1,660 crores. That means the price was made almost three times, two and a half times. And out of that, it was found later that out of the 60,000 crores that we would be paying for the purchase of these 36 aircraft, about one third, that is more than 20,000 crores, would be paid to this company of Anil Ambani called Reliance Defense. That company was a 2 week old company with no history of manufacturing any defense equipment, when all of Anil Ambani's companies were steeped in more than 40,000 crores of unpaid debt to various public sector banks. Most of them had become bankrupt. Anil Ambani's company had been charge-sheeted in the 2G scam, and yet a deal in which number of aircrafts to be purchased was reduced from 126 to 36. Transfer of technology and make in India was thrown out. Hindustan Aeronautics was thrown out. And a bogus company of a crony or friend of the Prime Minister named Anil Ambani was brought in to get 20,000 crores out of this. And this has been done by the Prime Minister himself. And yet, the BJP and the Prime Minister would want us to believe that there has not been a major scam under this Modi government. This is a scam which is far, far bigger than any defense scam that we have seen earlier. You know, Bofors was a 64 crore commission scam in the purchase of Bofors guns. This is a more than 20,000 crore scam. This 20,000 crores being given to Anil Ambani's company is nothing but commission. And not only that, you have broken the back of the Indian Air Force by reducing the planes from 126 to 36. You have finished India's self-reliance in making and producing these aircrafts. You have thrown out our public sector undertaking, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, which is the only company having experience in manufacturing aircraft, and you have brought in a crony only to so that commissions can be paid to him. As I said, this scam of the Rafale deal is not only the largest defense scam, it has severely compromised India's security. And then, in order to justify this corrupt contract, the government and its ministers speak lie after lie. Mr. Jaitley says that no, the government had no role in bringing in Ambani. This was a decision entirely of that Dassault company. When the defense procurement rules, the offset guidelines framed by this government say that no offset contract can be given without the express approval of the defense minister. And 3 days ago, Mr. Hollande, the former French president with whom the Prime Minister Modi signed this contract for 36 planes, he said that the French people had no option in order to choose the offset partner in this contract, because the Indian government itself said that you must have Ambani as your offset partner. And then Nirmala Sitaraman, the defense minister, says that no, the deal was changed from 126 to 36 planes because Indian Air Force did not have the infrastructure to park these planes. For the last 15 years, the Indian Air Force has been asking for 126 planes. And this lady, who is a complete illiterate in defense matters, this lady says that Indian Air Force did not have the infrastructure to park these planes. And then she says that no, Hindustan Aeronautics did not have the capacity to make these planes. Arre, when Parikar was asked, why was this 126 reduced to 36? He was the defense minister at that time. He said, well, I don't know, it is the prime minister's decision. He says, perhaps it must have been done because 126 would have been too expensive. 126 would have cost 90,000 crores, which means 715 crores per aircraft. And now you go and purchase 36 aircraft for 60,000 crores, which means 1,660 crores per aircraft. I mean, it's an astounding government. And this, and then the Indian Air Force officers, the vice chief, is being made to lie by this government in order to defend this deal. This Indian Air Force vice chief, he probably wants to become the chief. So therefore he says that, look, we said that this 126 should be reduced to 36. Absolute lie. If this fellow has the temerity to file an affidavit on this, he will be sent to jail. I can guarantee that. At no stage did the Indian Air Force or the Defense Ministry say that this number of aircraft should be reduced from 126 to 36. In fact, all the Indian Air Force chiefs have been saying that this government has broken the back of the Indian Air Force by reducing 126 to 36. It has compromised India's security. And the Rafale scam is only the most recent scam to have erupted. Very recently, just a few months ago, in January, we saw these two people, uncle and nephew, Mehul Choksi, whom Mr. Modi affectionately calls Mehul Bhai. He says, Hamare Mehul Bhai, my Mehul Bhai. Now, this fellow, Modi's Mehul Bhai, ran away with more than 13,000 crores of funds that he had taken from the bank. Thereafter, Nirav Modi ran away with another 13,000 crores that he had taken from our banks. And after running away from this country, this Nirav Modi gets himself photographed in Davos in the World Economic Forum along with Mr. Modi, our Prime Minister. After running away with 13,000 crores, he goes to the World Economic Forum and gets himself photographed with Mr. Modi. And then they make a show of trying to get them back to India. This Mehul Bhai was given NOC by the Indian government in order to get citizenship in Antigua. And now they are trying to make a show of trying to get them back. And before that, when this gentleman, Mr. Modi, was the chief minister of Gujarat, he announced with great fanfare that we have found gas. Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation has found the world's largest gas field. And he took 20,000 crores from our banks for this Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation and gave that money for drilling contracts to his crony companies, and they did not take out even 1 ounce of gas. 20,000 crores went down the drain to cronies of Mr. Modi on gas which was non-existent, but he just gasped that I have got the world's largest gas find here in Gujarat. I mean, it's astounding. And yet this gentleman says that there has been no scam under my watch. And how will any scam be discovered? You have not appointed a Lokpal. When this government came, they came on the promise that they will appoint a strong Lokpal immediately. Law had been passed before this government came. It's been 4.5 years, no Lokpal has been appointed. And they have now made an amendment in the Prevention of Corruption Act, which has now become the Promotion of Corruption Act. It should now be renamed as the Promotion of Corruption Act. The amendment says that no corruption investigation or inquiry can be done without the approval of the person who has done the corruption. They say that first you take the approval of the thief in order to investigate the thief. I mean, this is the amendment that they have made in the Prevention of Corruption Act, and they have not notified the whistleblower law, which came into force in almost 5 years ago. For 5 years, they have not operationalized the whistleblower law, which allows whistleblowers within the government to blow the whistle about corruption that they have seen, which gives them protection from being victimized by this corrupt, their corrupt bosses, etc. That law has not been notified. They have destroyed the Central Vigilance Commission by appointing 3 corrupt people in that. All the 3 people there are people with questionable credentials in the Central Vigilance Commission. They are destroying the Central Bureau of Investigation. They have appointed a gentleman as the special director. He is from Gujarat. He is supposed to be reporting almost every day to Amit Shah. That gentleman, Rakesh Asthana, is himself being investigated by the CBI in a 20,000 crore scam, money laundering scam. And yet that person has been appointed as the special director of the CBI. And then you say that no major scam has erupted under this government. Arre, how will it erupt? You are not even allowing this Rafale, Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi have come out on their own. If there was a Lokpal, if there was a proper Prevention of Corruption Act, if there was a proper CVC, if there was a proper CBI, then hundreds of more scams which are being done under this government would have come out by now. And you are weakening the Right to Information Act. This government is singularly responsible for trying to destroy the Right to Information Act. They are doing it firstly by not appointing information commissioners or appointing weak and pliable information commissioners. Very recently, they have passed, or they are trying to pass, an amendment saying that information commissioners will not have a fixed tenure. Information commissioners will not have a fixed salary fixed earlier by the Act. That the tenure as well as the salary of information commissioners will be decided by the government itself. Which means that you want to have information commissioners who are completely under your control and totally pliable, and till that happens, they are not filling up the vacancies in the Right to Information Act. And this government has made such retrograde changes in the law relating to political funding. You see, the problem of money, power in elections is a well-known problem. As Anna Hazare said, that in India, elections have become a game where if you have a lot of money, you can use that money to come to power, and once you are in power, you can use your power to make a lot of money. So it's a vicious circle of money to power and power to money. And that is why it was essential to bring about those changes which would reduce the role of money power in elections. Now, for example, today there is a law which limits the amount of money that candidates can spend in elections. But this limit is exceeded by the big political parties sometimes 20 times, 50 times. Sometimes they spend, when the limit may be 20 lakhs, they spend even 10 crores or 20 crores in for their elections. Now this happens because they are allowed to spend money in cash. When this note ban or demonetization was done, this Prime Minister said that we want the people and the farmers and the poor people to become cashless, which means that they should spend every money and they should receive money only through bank transactions. Now, it's very difficult to ask poor people who may be illiterate, who don't even have bank accounts, to become cashless. But it was certainly possible to ask political parties and candidates to become cashless. Once you had made that law, and if you had said that any violation of this law, any candidate or party caught spending or receiving money in cash will be disqualified. Suppose you had made that law, then it would have been much easier to enforce the limit on election expenses. But instead of doing that, they have done exactly the opposite. They have now amended the law. Earlier the law said, no political party or candidate can accept foreign funds. Now they have amended that law to say that political parties and candidates can accept foreign funds from subsidiaries of foreign companies. So today, for example, this Dassault Reliance company. Now, this is a subsidiary of a foreign company in a way, not subsidiary actually, this Dassault has 49% share. Now you have given 20,000 crores of offset contracts to this Dassault, to this Reliance. Suppose Reliance now gives 10,000 crores to the BJP or to various candidates of the BJP as donations. Earlier this was not allowed. Today it has become allowed. Earlier there was a limit to the amount of money that corporations can give as donations to political parties. It was maximum 7.5% of your profits. Today that limit has been removed. And not only that, you have now allowed corporations to give money, to give donations by these political bonds, electoral bonds. These are faceless, nameless, anonymous instruments of political funding, which means that if today this Reliance company buys 10,000 crores of electoral bonds and gives them to the BJP and its candidates as a kickback for having given them 20,000 crores in this Rafale deal, nobody will even come to know that Reliance has given this 10,000 crores through electoral bonds, because its anonymous funding has now been allowed. And these changes, which are totally retrograde changes, these are being touted as electoral reforms, just as the Rafale deal is being touted as a great deal for the national security of the country. I mean, you can just go on saying that black is white and white is black and you expect people to believe all this. So that is why I say that this government is the most corrupt government in the history of this country. It has not only indulged in massive acts of corruption, destroying the national security of this country, destroying the Air Force, etc. It has also destroyed all the laws and institutions dealing with corruption. And that is why it has become essential and important for all people of this country to rise up once again, which people did when the anti-corruption Lokpal movement gained momentum. The time has come for the people of this country to come together and rise again against this destruction of anti-corruption laws and institutions that is going on, and this massive corruption that is going on. But the attack on our anti-corruption institutions and laws is only the tip of the iceberg. What we are seeing today in this country is an attack on the very foundations of our republic. We have never seen a situation where if you say anything against the government, a lynch mob is let loose on you. A lynch mob, which could be a social media lynch mob, and that social media lynch mob will abuse you in the most vulgar, filthy abuse possible, will threaten you with rape and murder, and that lynch mob is being directly controlled by the Prime Minister, who not only follows but encourages this lynch mob by inviting them to his Prime Minister's residence, getting selfies taken with them, and allowing these people to post those selfies on their Facebook pages by saying that I am proud to be followed by the Prime Minister. This kind of vulgar, filthy, abusive, violent culture is being promoted by the Prime Minister himself. This has not happened at any time in our history. It has not happened, but no head of state anywhere in the world has done what we are seeing in this country. But this country and its people have always risen whenever the republic has been threatened, whenever fundamental rights have been threatened. And I'm sure that the people of this country